Better you should smoke pot than buy all those records. And would you please stop playing with matches?
Easy to be wowed by that, and then you miss something right around the corner, which is really interesting and probably would fit in more people's homes. So this is a clone of which Micro-Psyche?
Of the Micro-Psyche 5000, made by a Chinese company named Amari, and we import it into Europe and modify it to lift it on a completely new performance level for that price range. It consists of all machined massive aluminium, has the options to mount three tone arms, features a real stroboscope, fine adjustment on speed by potentiometers of 33 and 45, have a separate double linear 24 volt DC power supply, quite hefty, 4 kilograms on its own. And what we do, we fit in better potentiometers. We fit the table with our SDP, with a decoupled platter, spindle totally isolated from the bearing, and a height equalizer for the arm bases to make up for the additional height, of course. So we increase, of course, the platter mass. We increase the inertia quite a lot. We decouple from any possible vibrations from the axis to be promoted into the spindle and therefore in the record. And furthermore, we are now seeing here a table which has, in contrast to the original Micro-Psyche, a totally different bearing. It consists of a 18 millimeter ceramic axis, very, very precisely machined, resting on an oil bubble.
Oh.
And it runs extremely smooth.
It'll spin forever.
No, not forever, but it spins for quite some time. What spins literally almost forever is the Apolyt. If you cut this belt, which is hard to cut, by the way, it's an aramide belt, which has no elasticity of its own.
Right.
If you cut it while you are at 33.33, it stops after 6.5 days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, my God. Is there any purpose to that cutout at the top of this motor housing?
Yeah, simply that we forgot to bring the cover.
Oh.
So there is a cover, okay, which gives you still some view of the LED initializing here of the speed. But that's all what's missing.
And so when you sell it in modified form, how much does it sell for?
In modified form, it sells retails for around 8,000.
Wow, that's...
Yeah. And you get 50 kilograms of solid machined turntable, separate power supply, separate motor stand, everything very well machined, solidity and the ability to mount three tone arms of your choice and interacting with a classical Micro-Psyche onboard system.
And what does it sell for without your modifications?
We do not give it away. You can certainly buy it somewhere in China without our modifications, but I wouldn't recommend.
Yeah.
And we do not give it away without the modifications.
No. And would you consider like exporting this modified version overseas?
We were asked by our American distributor, and we are in negotiations.
Yeah, that's an incredible deal.
It is. I believe put it that way. In terms of performance, it has very little competition below 20,000.
Yeah.
Very little.
Yeah, and it's a cool looking turntable.
It's a cool classical looking turntable. Yep. Yes, it is a Micro Psyche clone, but there are way worse around than this one.
I'm sure.
Way worse.
Okay, thank you.
You're most welcome.
Too high up for me to see.
For me too.
So. Well, yeah, so what you can see here is the Valore 425 Lite, our entry model, and available in black and white, and this retails for 900 euros, tone arm included, and dust cover. So down here we've got the Pianosa, which is the entry level of the curvy design turntable, and this particular model is in all black, and these retails for 2,700 euros. And it's a top plinth. The upper plinth is made in MDF. The lower plinth is MDF as well when it's in black or white, or if it's in walnut, Italian walnut, it's just hardwood.
That's a little more expensive.
This.
Get it in walnut?
Yeah, in walnut it's 2,700 and in MDF it's 2,300 euros.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's a bit more expensive.
And this one?
And this is the Giglio, so this is very similar in looks when compared to Pianosa, but it has higher mass and a completely different motor. So everything inside is different, even though the shape from the outside looks kind of similar.
Taller
plata, yeah, and a different material for the upper plinth, which is acrylic in this case.
And this is palm?
Yes, exactly. And this retails for 3,500 euros.
Very attractive.
Yeah.
Which counts in this one.
And on the other side, you'll see that we have other two models.
Two chairs.
Five turntables. And in the middle, you can see the flagship Mediterraneo, which is a 25 kilos turntable. So it's kind of the same shape because this shape provides extra rigidity to the overall structure. And what you end up having is 25 kilos that will sound as double the mass. So without the need of taking up too much space, it's still extra region. And on the sides, you'll see the Valore 425 Plus, which is an upgraded model from the Lite. So it has a different motor, different plinth, different materials for the platter.
This is Valore?
Yes.
And so what does this cost?
This retails for 1400, depending on the finish. So in this case, the acrylic is 1400, the walnut is 1400 as well, the black and white, they retail for 1200.
So this is the lowest?
Yes.
That's very handsome.
Oh, thank you. Still the same material for the platter,
yeah.
Tone arm included and dust cover included as well. And these are all made in Florence by us, so we do everything basically, from the motor, the boards of the motor, the electronics, the software that controls the electronics, so we do everything in-house.
So your motor is done in-house?
Yeah. And the tone arm as well. And you can see that the tone arm has an aluminium pipe and some new anti-skating in this case, and some custom molded parts.
That's impressive that everything is done in-house.
Yeah, we try to do as much as we can.
You do everything you're doing, definitely as much as you can.
Yeah, apart from like the ball bearing system, because sometimes the ball bearing, especially in the upgraded model, we use ceramic balls,
right.
And they come from Germany because they have a very, very precise and strict tolerance.
Okay. Great, thank you. H10 Gold Note Phono Stage. And how much does that cost?
This retails for 1,200. And it features six EQ curves, and two separate inputs, MM, MC, gain and load adjustments.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Performer.
That's me. How are you?
I know you in from internet, Stereophile.
Oh.
I've seen your YouTuber report.
I work hard at those.
Very good.
Thank you. Enjoying the show?
Sorry?
Are you enjoying the show?
Yeah, no. No as an expositor.
But you're enjoying being...
Yes. I've been in a consumer reality show. In Las Vegas. Las Vegas.
This is better.
The actual turntable is called the AD1, and the idea is it equalizes the
tension.
Force. The tension on the motor. So instead of the motor being pulled over all the time on one side,
right,
the force is equal. Also, the forces on the plat are equal. Massive contact area, so the actual drive is very grippy, if you know what I mean.
Right.
But the other quite unique thing about this deck is that it's got what we call a light speed controller. So instead of the motor being perfectly controlled, which is what most manufacturers do, we actually monitor the platter speed,
right,
and then feed that through to the motor. And we do it in such a way that it doesn't create massive jitter, because I've experimented with coders which do a million samples per second or whatever, you know, the top ones do. And they introduce jitter because they're over-controlling the motor.
Yep.
So we use an analog load compensation and only monitor the platter once every resolution. The accuracy is still better than direct drive, well, most direct drive, probably not the latest techniques.
Right.
But it's down into the 0.04% wow and flutter figures. Absolute speed stability is immeasurably low, because you could sit and stare at the strobe literally all day and you'll never move a graduation.
Right.
So it's super accurate. The sound quality, you can hear that it's very, very speed stable. And that adds a sort of security to the music that's almost subliminal, but it's there, and people do notice it.
Yeah. Now, are those just pulleys, or
these are idler wheels?
Yeah. So that's the motor. That's the one motor.
Yeah, you got two motors.
Oh,
one on each side.
I was trying to look back there, but I couldn't get back there.
Yeah.
No, that's okay.
Well, I can take the cover off.
That's fine. No, that's well. Okay, let's see if I can do it this way. Okay. And is this in production yet, or is this just a prototype?
Just about to go into production.
And this is the Genie.
Yeah, it's actually made by Origin Live. That's ourselves.
Yes.
For a company called Genie, which is a startup in Germany.
Oh.
Although the actual owner of Genie has been dealing with hi-fi for the last 30 years.
So
he's a very experienced
guy. Do you know what he's going to sell it for?
It's 12,000 euros.
Yeah. And what is it? What is the construction? What is it made of?
Solid wood base, and the platters are fairly confidential material. It's a multi-layer platter.
Okay.
Because it reduces, well, a lot of people are making multi-layer platters now.
So it looks like it's an aluminum, and then a sandwich of aluminum, and then on top, below the mat,
it's a plastic.
It's like palm type material.
Yeah. Really important, the plastic layer, because you get a lens effect. That's a magnetic effect that interferes with the cartridge. A lot of manufacturers seem completely oblivious of this, but it's very noticeable once you get... You know, we have to get a certain distance away, or the aluminium is going to interfere with your cartridge.
Okay. All right, well, thank you. And I'm going to keep moving on.
Thank you.
I'll tell you a secret, it's true to the face. Oh, no, just for me. 52 kg. Hello, Mr. Freeman.
Hi there. I'm just covering turntables and analogs.
So yeah, I can just pass by this.
And look at all this beautiful stuff, and I have to pass it by because there's so much.
Art liked it. Art took a photo, so. Yeah,
there's so much analog now that I used to come to the show and
isn't
cover
crazy?
The analog in a short period
we have
of
more,
time.
We have more turntables than in the good old times.
That's right. It is more and better.
Yeah.
And people who are not into it, who don't understand it, can now sit in a room and get forced to listen to a record and go, wow.
Yeah.
And then they're sold, and it's a done deal.
Well, yeah. Great.
You have a great show.
Have a good time.
One of the things I find at these shows, you can go through the whole show, and then like on the last day now, you can go through again and see things you missed the first time, and have a totally different experience and a totally different experience. Look, I didn't see this turntable the last time.
No pictures, please.
No pictures. They didn't want pictures. They come to a show and they don't want pictures. They come to a show and they don't want pictures of their products. Because it's so exclusive. It's so fantastic and exclusive that they don't want any pictures. I think that's fucking idiots. But okay, that's me. Okay. You know, we've never seen inside the Fern and Roby turntable. Now we can look inside and see.
What's cool about what he's done,
look how cool that is.
This is the preamp that actually is magnetically inserted in the back, so you can swap that.
I like this guy's products. I must get involved.
Okay.
A lot of people will see this. I don't want to put the pressure on you now,
okay,
but a lot.
Should I introduce myself?
Yes, you should.
Hello, welcome to our booth on the Munich Hi-Fi Show. We are Opera Audio and representing the Consonance product line. This year's show we focus on the analog, the vinyl players, the turntables, and additional the headphone amplifiers. At the moment we have four different models starting from 1,000 euro and going up to the front model, our new most powerful headphone amplifier.
Okay, but I'm not covering that. I'm just covering vinyl and analog.
Oh, okay. No problem. Then we go back to...
Yeah, let's go back here.
That what you are liking most.
Yes.
This one is our new top model. Last year, we also introduced the turntable called Air 1. Last year, we introduced it with the air breathing at the tangential tone arm. This year, we also make focus on the platter, and we have... under the turntable, we also have an air bearing. Maybe you can show.
So there's your pump. There's your pumps.
There are the pumps. Two are for the Air 1, one for the platter, one for the arm, and the third pump is for the Valkyrie. Maybe you know this turntable. It's an older model, and we pimped it for that show. And beside this, maybe you can show.
Oh.
There's also the air bearing, the secret air bearing. You just need a little power. When you go from the top side, maybe you see the
I can see
less power, and it's moving, and don't stop because the air
is floating.
It's floating.
So now, what is this? What does the Valkyrie cost? What does this cost?
We didn't do the final calculation. I think with if you put all, you can place three tone arm, and if you do the highest upgrade also with the air bearing for the platter, I think you will be around about 15,000 euro.
Okay.
And the Valkyrie start at 4,000 euro.
So this is opera audio consonants, and they have a thread based machine. This looks like, very nice looking thread based machine. And then this is another, this is the Isolde. This turntable with a, this looks very much like with a captured air bearing. They're not messing around. The LT15. Oh, I didn't even, this is the Air 1. And this one is the Die Valkyrie in the air. Arctic birch. All right, so let's start over again. So this is the Valkyrie, and this starts at 4,000 euro?
Yeah.
And then it...
I think it will end, when you do the highest upgrades, you will be around about 15,000 euro, with three tone arms and air bearing at the platter.
Okay, and this,
this one starts at close under 8,000 euro. The German retail price is 7,800 euro.
Okay.
The tone arm is included with the pump for the tone arm, but you have a regular bearing for the platter if you want the highest model of the Air 1. We didn't do the final calculation, but it will be around about 12,000 euro, I think.
Interesting. And this is your, this is your baby?
Oh, this is the lower middle range. This is the Isolde, the upgrade of the Isolde. It's called MK2 now. The design changed. We also have regular bearing under that with a sub platter, and on top the huge platter, a two-pointed tone arm, or you can use a regular tone arm.
So this is, this is a, this is a dual pivot arm.
Yeah, two-pointed, two pivots. Yes, uh-huh. Right. The two pivot have the benefits of the one pivot tone arm, but much more easy.
And stability. Stability.
Yeah, it's all about stability.
I try to say that in my everyday life, but it doesn't work.
Stability is most important.
Yes.
You have a controlman. You can install the speed of the platter.
Right.
Each speed, it depends on 54 or 33.
Right.
And it's controlling the movement in every second or more than in a second. So it's very constant moving, very important.
Yeah.
Very simple to start. It's a classical design, but in a fresh design.
Very nice. What is that? What does that sell for?
The retail price in Germany is about starting at 3,000 euro, and then it depends on the tone arm you are placing on it. Opera Audio is from Beijing.
Beijing.
Yeah, they also produce four different brands. You can check it on the if you do a little search, a little research on the internet, you find some other brands. Opera Audio is
the OEM
for many OEM business. But consonants, the product line, is a personal interest of the owner of Opera Audio. So it's very, very high quality.
Sure.
And
it's his baby. His name's on it.
His
name is on it.
Leo is the big boss from Beijing.
Ah. Okay, great. Well, thank you so much for showing
me
all
this. You're
welcome. And then they have a string-based cleaning machine, too.
Oh, yeah. I hope it will be on the market in the middle end of this year. This is the close to the final prototype. So I hope it will be ready for
any price.
Oh, it's hard to say because we didn't have the final calculation. I think it will be around about 2,000, 2,500, maybe closer to 3,000.
Yeah.
Hard to say. We have a smaller cleaning machine already on the market that we could recommend it.
And what is this year?
This is a different brand. We support them because we really like the products they are producing. It's all about cleaning the vinyl, cleaning the needle.
And you very, and you, very cool. You put that out, you hold, it's a handheld cleaning machine?
Yeah, it's a handheld cleaning machine. Just
so a vacuum cleaner. And you put it on, you let your platter spin and then you hold that over the top?
Yeah, you have the platter spinning and just put it on.
Oh.
It's cleaning and also checking the anti-static.
Oh, good. That's good.
And over there,
That I know.
Second product.
Yeah, I've reviewed that already.
Yeah,
I've reviewed
it. Really, really great product.
Because it doesn't it doesn't have too high a speed of vibration.
Yeah.
It doesn't ruin anything.
Really, really awesome product. Yeah. And that's why we support them, because it's all about cleaning. And it must not only be the products from Consonance, which are really great. There are other brands who are really doing an awesome job.
Yep. Great. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is a warped record remover type machine.
Yes, and a relaxer. I think it's more a relaxer than a flattener.
Oh, so it's...
Because relaxing... you can relax every record.
So you mean like a demagnetizer type relaxer?
Yeah, not really. It's really...
therapy based?
it's really... excuse me, my English...
It's like mine isn't so good either. That's all I got.
You know, if you it comes from it's physics. If you heat a material very very slowly, heat up, and very very slowly cool down, this thermal process puts out the complete stress out of the material.
Okay.
And we do this with the vinyl record. So after that, there is no more stress inside, and every record after that sounds better.
But it doesn't remove warps?
Yes.
It does?
Yes.
But it doesn't get too hot?
No, it's all controlled and automatically.
How long does it take?
It takes 4 hours. So we have different programs. So we have a standard program for make flat. We have an expert program where you can change temperature. And we have a relaxed program just for relaxing. This is the shortest program, and temperature is a little bit lower.
And is there any danger of using this? Does it ever melt a record?
No.
And
not possible.
Can you close the top and let me see what it looks like?
Yeah.
So without the pen, there's a pen.
Yes.
Then and then you remove this pen.
No,
that's part of the deal. So, oh, that's not part. I see.
Yeah.
I thought that was.
So no, the pen is. We have magnetic switches. So you need this pen for switching.
Okay. Sorry.
So it's very reliable and very safe switching with the magnetic switches inside.
Audio fidelity improvement. And where is this made?
South Germany, engineered and hand built in South Germany, near Mercedes and Porsche, in Stuttgart.
How much does this cost?
€3,500 retail.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Cleaning machine for €129.
It's not a vacuum type machine. It is.
Sure, it is.
Oh.
It is. It is. We have one top with fresh water for wettening,
right.
And the other top is for the
detergent or some sort of cleaning fluid.
Yes.
So you apply the cleaning fluid, then you vacuum it off, then you apply the water just to give it a rinse. Is that how you do it?
No. So here are the fresh water and here the dirt water. So I said the fresh, also with the cleaning water, and you put after that you take this one for and you
you vacuum it off only in one shot. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. That's going to be €129. You think? You're hoping?
We hope we can do it for this price.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Is this overkill? I don't think so. There's no such thing as overkill in this business. So we have the Derenville Modulaire turntable. We saw this last year. And here it is with two arms. Two tangential tracking arms and one pivoted SME. So what does that cost, that assemblage cost? If somebody wanted to buy that, the whole thing, this whole thing.
The whole thing, like it's 10 here.
nearly 100,000.
100,000?
Yes.
That's all?
That's all.
That sounds really obnoxious, but considering. Yeah. It includes a power supply, so you can actually run the turntable.
Sure.
I've never heard Shelly Mann and Red Mitchell sound better than I'm hearing right now.
Yeah.
I'm not kidding. I'm just kidding. Okay. So this is the newcomer section where people who are just deciding to waste their time and money in this business have their stuff and get to be seen. So here's a beautiful wooden turntable. Klein. We like to show this stuff, so maybe next year these people will be old comers.
And basically the way it works is you have a polymer film with the conductive traces applied directly to it, and then we stack it one above each other. So basically in every layer the current will be flowing obviously in the opposite direction, so the layers will either attract each other or will kind of come apart, and this harmonic movement is going to create sound. And the diaphragm is sitting in a magnetic gap, so we're using the neodymium magnets and high quality steel so that we get the best kind of magnetic flux that we can.
And this is the name of the company, Aria Audio Labs?
Yes, Aria Audio Labs.
And will you be here next year with a full range loudspeaker using this technology?
We are hoping, but we're definitely trying to first focus on developing the driver so that it is the best it can be.
So you think it's better to build your own full loudspeaker or to license the technology to other companies?
Definitely not licensed. So we want to have the overview of what's happening with it, because the idea of a technology and the execution is kind of, I think it goes hand in hand, and it really shouldn't be given into someone else's hands to...
I like that attitude. That's good.
Yeah.
Well, hope to see you next year with a great sounding speaker.
Yep. See you next year.
You bet.
Yeah.
What is it?
Which color, man?
Whatever color you want.
Italian flag
or red and black and white, I don't care.
So this is a step-up transformer with a balanced and unbalanced input and outputs, and we can select gain 12, 24 and load, so we can interface with a high variety of MC cartridges.
Right.
And we are using 50% nickel core, so there is a high permeability core inside.
Right.
And
you wind these yourself?
No, we have been specifying. We specified the.
You have people.
Okay. Yeah, we specified the transformer characteristics. This is a technical paper which is available on our website, but it is by a professional, not by ourselves.
Right. So, is your amateur?
No, we're not. You know. No, I'm not that.
No, he's smart though. He has a company that specializes in that.
Correct.
To your specifications.
Yes, because you know, we just starting a company, so we cannot do everything in house. So we're just specifying our components, and somebody is building it, you know, up to spec and with high quality materials and technology. So the other interesting peculiarity is the panels. This is a sandwich. This is aluminum. This is a Hiron, and this is the interior of the inner chassis.
And you're trying to keep hum away from it. You're trying to
So we use magnets. So basically, we can change the front panel.
And that won't affect the transformer.
No, because the transformers are screened in a mu metal can.
Okay.
So there is no problem. And moreover.
No,
because magnets are, you know, a static magnetic field,
right.
So there is no, you know, no influence on the transformer.
Very stylish looking.
That's Italian design.
Of course, you can't help yourselves.
This is the AnalogPlanet.
Yes, black and silver.
Those are the normal colors.
Yeah, normal colors. I mean, we can offer any color, basically.
Right, but these colored ones will sell well to the female audiophile, so you'll sell two.
Myself, I would pick up the green one.
Yeah, I like that. No, that's cool.
So basically,
this is the basic version, let me call it basic, with the standard black and silver colors.
And but how much gain do you get out of this?
It's 12 or 24, because, you know, we can select the gain.
So how much are these going to cost, do you think?
So, the standard black and silver version will be 999 euros.
Oh, okay.
And we will ship it directly to your place. And in case you like it, you keep it. If you don't like it, you can ship it back and we will refund the customer. Any color version will be 1,250 euros.
Okay.
Same policy, we ship it, you like it, you keep it, you don't like it, you ship it back.
Right. And this brand is called La, what is it called? What's the name
Audio
of the
Audio Lab, yes. Audio Dynamica.
Oh. Audio Dynamica.
Yeah.
Okay. When do you expect to be able to ship these products?
I think a couple of those transformers, I think a couple of weeks. We only need to change the knobs. We are modifying knobs a little bit, and we're also changing the feed.
Yeah.
We're using one single big feed behind the bass.
Better idea.
Yeah, so that's kind of...
Those things tend to fall off, and they...
Yeah, you know what? Those are the very first batch of production that we had a few days ago.
Yeah.
So we need to finish up with...
And then you're planning on a phono preamp, too.
Yeah, there will be a phono preamp in same chassis with a separate power supply.
Right.
So it will be only MM because we have the step-up transformers. And
right.
It will be balanced, so we'll be using low-noise JFET.
Right.
Kind of 15 JFETs inside the
And when do you expect to have that?
I think a couple of months.
Yeah.
We have prototype runnings. We are receiving the small parts, FETs from USA, and we are starting assembling the new prototype.
Great.
So a couple of months will be available from
our
website.
Okay, well, good luck. And
we're working for
stay
that.
Stay in touch. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank
thanks.
You. The guy has red hair. I'm shocked. Why would he why would he have red hair?
It's so good hair.
Apparently the designer of this turntable has red hair, and I'm shocked. So he's using an Origin Live arm on there, obviously, or a copy of an Origin Live arm. I think it's, okay. And here's his, is this a direct drive? I think this is a direct drive turntable. Yeah, it looks like it is. And that's probably ceramic or some kind of plastic. It's too bad he's not here. And this is the Ankh. He's not here now. He stepped away. But I think this is kind of cool looking. Don't you? Ankh Limited. Okay, Ankh, you very much. Time. Okay, here's Mr. Blackstone reference. He's changed the torque on this a little bit. It still looks fantastic. And now we have to just keep moving. And there's, it shows up on Jeff's. This is an integrated amplifier?
Yeah, the Damon integrated amp. With it has phonos included in it.
I wish I had time to sit and listen, but I just don't. So
okay,
to keep moving.
You've got 1 hour.
Yeah. It's 1 hour left to cover way too much. Okay, thank you guys. So this year you've separated the phono preamp from the same chassis as the turntable was on.
Well, yeah. Usually we have SCPS underneath the table for convenience sake. We're using the SCPS as the base for the phono. The phono is suspended, and we can tune the suspension for the right resonance.
And this phono preamp was developed with True Life in Greece?
That's right, True Life Audio. It uses two 12 AX7s and two 12 AU7. It's a two input dual mono phono. This is the signal stage, and the power supply is a little bit more than a dual mono design because it uses actually two AC cords and two power buttons, power switches. Mm-hmm. And it's tube regulated. And here is
I know him. And he
from
knows
True
me.
Life Audio.
How are you?
I love it. Bye.
This looks great.
Yeah.
It's good.
He designed it.
Good partner.
Yeah, I know. The best team. We have the best team.
And thank you, Analog. Is it...
Planet.
Yeah, Analog Planet. Sorry. Long show. Long
okay, so we're at the end of the show. We're at Avid, which we almost missed. So.
Well, we've got the... new on display this year, we've got a brand new Ingenium with a, now it's going to have a replaceable tone arm.
Like so an arm board.
Yeah, so you're going to be able to replace the arm board. So whereas before it was a fixed item, now you're going to be able to replace that. It's also going to have a individual power supply, so external to the where the old one used to be
built in
and then
what is this purple material?
So if a customer wants to have something a little bit different with a new they can have their own color. So if you want it the same color as their car, if you want it the same color as your lovely blue suit there.
Wow, snazzy.
Yeah,
this is the one that you stole from Prince's estate, didn't you?
What's that?
This was in Prince's house.
Oh,
and you
yeah,
guys stole it from
him.
Yeah, shame on shame on you.
people are coming, a lot of people are taking photos of
that.
This is going to be the standard color for the Ingenium
suit. How much extra does it cost to get the mirrored?
About £150.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, and then if you look down here, we've got a new design for the bearing housing. It's got this lovely
Oh, wow. That's beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
That's cool.
It's a shame it's right down there because lots of people have missed that. But,
That doesn't have it though.
It's got a black one on there.
Oh, on the other side. Yeah, it's only on one side.
Yeah, it's only one side.
Okay. And that's all you need to know. Why are you going to stand in the back and look at your bearing?
That's it.
I mean, why would you look at the bearing in the front either? But if you're going to look, that's a cool way to look at it.
That's it. And you've got the, we've got the nice, the big A that's kind of synonymous with the Avid brand.
Yep.
On there as well. So that's number one. And that was number two. We've got the, we've got a black Acutus. This one's got some accents on it of a chrome chocolate colour. So this one will be retailing at a lower price than the chrome version because we're able to reproduce it with a lot less waste.
Sure.
So that's.
So what arm is that?
That is the Avid tone arm. That is the baritone.
Oh, okay.
It's currently a working prototype. You're actually listening to it now. It's on the other one over there. So we've got this is the full black version of the Acutus. So this is the baritone tone arm. Like I said, it's a working prototype. So there's a few little adjustments that need to be made when we get back. And
what's that arm going to sell for?
That's going to be between £2,000 and £3,000.
Oh,
okay. So that's our entry level model. And then we've got the next one will follow soon after, and by this show next year we'll have
And the ones that you showed last year, are those actually being produced? Those cool looking ones with the...
This is number one of them, and then the next one...
But you showed that really interesting looking one.
That's the top level one. That we'll be playing that at the show next year.
Oh, okay.
Yep, so that's the guarantee.
Okay, great.
This is actually our own cartridge.
Oh.
So we've produced our own cartridge from the ground up. That's
really?
Completely our own work, yeah. So there's a couple of little things that need to be changed on it.
It's a moving coil?
Yep, moving coil, really low output. But obviously with our own phono stages, that's easy.
Right.
We can easily deal with that.
What's it called?
It's Ruby at the moment.
Groovy?
Yep, because it's got a Ruby cantilever.
Oh, Ruby. I think it said Groovy. Okay.
Yeah, Ruby, like the jewel.
Okay. Cool. Okay.
You know how important I am in this business? Look, the high-end show gave me my own bus. We've just left the convention center, and I'm getting a chauffeured bus ride back to my hotel.